Okay, so the four, five function operations day two, we're going to look at composition of functions. So being able to compose functions and simplifying the order in which, specifying the order in which functions are applied and describing the domain of composite functions. So in the previous function operations, we use traditional operations like add, subtract, multiply, divide. In this one, this is a new operation, I'm assuming, which is composition. So composition is creating what is created when one function is substituted into another function. And so the operation, it's an open dot, so is a symbol to denote composition. So this dot tells you composition. This is a little more, this notation is a little more descriptive in showing that I'm taking g of x and I'm plugging it into f of x is what this means. So here's an example of function composition. So they've got f of x is 3x plus 2 and g of x is x squared plus x. So f of g of x, so notice I'm plugging g of x into f of x. I'm taking the entire function for g of x, which is x squared plus x, and I'm plugging it in as the x in f. So f only had one x, so I'm going to replace that x in f with x squared plus x. Okay, so that would be an example of this. Versus if I have it the opposite, g of f of x, so f is second, I'm plugging f of x into g of x. F of x is that 3 over x plus 2. I'm going to plug that into every x in g. So g actually had two different x's, right? It had x squared and x. So I would replace both of those x's with the entire function for f, 3 over x plus 2, 3 over x plus 2. So these are not simplified the way that we will do this. So let's look at example 5. We're going to do both directions with two different sets of functions. So for example 5a, we've got f of x is the square root of x plus 7, and then g of x is 2x minus 5. So they want us to find both. So f of g is telling us they want us to find f of g of x. So what we're going to do is we're going to replace the variables in f with the function g of x. So g of x is 2x minus 5. So I'm going to plug 2x minus 5 in the variables for f. So f was the function, the square root of x plus 7. So if I have the square root of x, and I'm going to write that, but I'm going to erase it, so don't write it down if you're writing in pen, plus 7. Okay, so f is the square root of x plus 7. I'm taking any x in that equation, so the x here, and I'm going to replace it with the function for g. So instead of x here, I'm going to write the function for g, which was 2x minus 5. Okay, so any place that there was an x in f, I'm going to replace it with the equation for g. So 2x minus 5 plus 7. If I simplify this, there's nothing in front of the 2x minus 5, so I can just ignore my parentheses. So I have 2x minus 5 plus 7. If I combine like terms, that means I have the square root of 2x plus 2. Okay, I'm doing this backwards for part 2. So I want to find g of f of x, meaning I want to take the equation for f, and I'm going to plug it into the x for in g. There was, again, only one x here. So I'm doing g of, I'm plugging in the square root of x plus 7 anywhere that I have an x in g. So in g, I only had one x. So I'm going to rewrite it with just a big gap where my x was instead of doing the erase thing I did last time. So I've got 2 times something minus 5, right? I'm substituting in for x. I'm substituting in the expression, the square root of x plus 7. Notice that when I do this, I have parentheses. So technically I should distribute, but this is one unit. It's all under a square root. So that means that this 2 is just a coefficient. I cannot distribute it in. So I have 2 times the square root of x plus 7 minus 5. So this almost looks like the graph of a square root function, right? Like my 2 is my a, and then negative 7 is my h, and negative 5 is my k, right? So that would be something if I needed to graph it, which we will look at graphs of things next lesson. Okay, so function composition. I'm taking the variables in one equation and replacing it with an entirely different equation. So when we look at example 5b here, notice that f of x has 2 variables. So that means that when I do this first problem, this first one is telling me f of g of x, I'm going to have to plug g of x into 2 different places now in my f. So g of x is 4 minus x. So I'm going to plug 4 minus x into every x in f of x. Okay, so f of x is the equation x squared plus x plus 2. I have 2 x's. So that means I'm going to leave 2 blanks. So I've got x squared plus x plus 2, okay? So again, instead of writing the x's, I just wrote a big blank with parentheses around it, because that's where I'm gonna substitute in g of x. So g of x is 4 minus x. So I'm replacing both of these x's with 4 minus x, 4 minus x. And then I'm going to simplify. So this one's a lot more complicated. A, because I have a binomial squared, 4 minus x squared means that I have to multiply out. So I have to multiply out 4 minus x times itself, right? If it's squared. So 4 minus x times 4 minus x is 4 minus x squared. Plus I have no coefficient on the parentheses, so that's like distributing a 1, so nothing's changing here. So plus 4 minus x, and then I still have that plus 2. So when I distribute my square, right, I'm squaring, multiplying times itself means I have to distribute 4 times 4 minus x. So 4 times 4 is 16. 4 times negative x is minus 4x. Then I have to take and distribute the negative x into that same binomial. So negative x times 4 is minus 4x, and then negative x times x is plus x squared. And then if I combine like terms over here, since I can, I've got 4 plus 2 I can add, so I still have minus x plus 6. So now if I combine like terms with everything, if I start with my highest degree, that's x squared. I only have one term with x squared. Then I have negative 4x, negative 4x, and negative x. So that's going to give me minus 9x. And then finally, I have 16 and 6. So that's going to give me plus 22. So f of g of x, where I'm plugging g of x into f, I'm composing f with g, that gives me x squared minus 9x plus 22. If I do this the opposite order, if I do g of f of x, then I'm taking f of x, which was my x squared plus x plus 2, and I'm plugging that into the equation for g. Okay, so the equation for g only has a single x, 4 minus x. So 4 minus, remember we're putting parentheses for us to replace the x with our function f, which was x squared plus x plus 2. So this one's going to be a lot cleaner because we only had one x to plug into, and it's not square, right? I don't have to multiply anything through where I'm doing multiple steps. I do have a negative sign in front of where I plugged in. So remember, that's like distributing a negative 1 versus here it was a positive 1. The positive 1 didn't change anything, right? This stayed plus, this stayed minus. Now it's going to change all the signs because negative 1 times x squared is negative x squared. Negative 1 times x is negative x. And negative 1 times 2 is negative 2. So I've got 4 minus x squared minus x minus 2. When I combine like terms, notice I only have the constants as like terms. So I'm going to keep my negative x squared minus x to write this in standard form. And then 4 minus 2 is 2. So g of f of x, so composing f into g, gives us negative x squared minus x plus 2. Okay, so that is substituting an equation or a function into another function using composition. We're going to go back to example 4 that we skipped and look at what happens when I do composition, but I'm evaluating it at a value. So notice that there's something different here. So we have a number instead of an x in our composition expression, right? Here, these were x's. So our answer had an x. When I have a problem like this where there's no x, it's a value, my answer is just going to be a single number. Okay, so I'm going to find a number answer. I'm going to work from the inside out with these problems, meaning I'm going to start here with g of 3. So I'm going to look at, okay, what is g of 3? So what do I get when I plug the number 3 into the x and g? So there's only one of them. So I'm going to take and I'm going to evaluate what is 3 times 3 squared minus 1, okay? So that's something that I'm going to plug into a scientific calculator. Okay, so in a calculator, or I could type into Desmos, I'm going to evaluate 3 times 3 squared minus 1. So I'm going to type this in exactly as I see it. So I'm going to type 3 and then parentheses, 3 squared, whoops, and then minus 1. And so that is going to give me negative 27. Okay, so that tells me that this is negative 27. Okay, so if I go back to my original problem, I was looking for f of g of 3. I just found out that g of 3 is negative 27. So if I'm evaluating f of g of 3, that means that I'm going to plug that negative 27 into f. I'm going to change this color just so I can kind of see where this came from. Okay, so I'm going to take in my f now, so f has one x as well. I'm going to plug in negative 27 for that f, x in f. So if f is 2 times x minus 1, I'm going to substitute in negative 27. So if I evaluate that, so 2 times negative 27 minus 1, that's going to give me the value of negative 55. Okay, so if I look at this then, f of g of 3 then is negative 55. Okay, so I did this really in two parts. So the first part was finding g of 3. And then the second part was finding the whole thing. That was finding f of negative 27. And that gives me the solution to f of g of 3. Okay, so let's look at the next one. So for the first one, we've got f of 2. Okay, so we're going to start with f of 2. And so f of 2 means we're going to take and plug 2 in for every x in f, which is just 1. So 2 times 2 minus 1. I don't need a calculator for this one. That's 4 minus 1, so 3. Okay, so that gives me 3. For that, goodness. Sorry. Three. There we go. Okay. So that is F of two, right? So then I have to go and I have to look at G of that value that I just got, which was three. So the next thing I'm going to check is, okay, if I'm evaluating G of three then. So this is building from inside out. So I plug the two into the F and I plug my answer into G as my second step. So G is three times X squared minus one. So I'm replacing my X with the three. So three times three squared minus one is going to give me my answer. So if I evaluate that, three times three squared minus one is going to give us 26. So that means that the answer here is 26. So that means that G of F of two is 26. Again, so it's building from the right to the left. So from the inside to the outside. Okay, so one last to try. We've got G of F of zero. So the first thing we're gonna start with is F of zero. So F of zero, we're gonna plug zero in for X. We only had one X. So two times zero minus one is negative one. I keep forgetting that I'm trying to change colors here, is negative one. So I get negative one for this guy. So I'm gonna take the negative one then and plug it into there, right? I plug zero into F, I got negative one. I'm gonna plug negative one into G. So G of negative one is my last step to find my answer. I only have one X again, so three times negative one squared minus one. Be careful with this because it's negative. So I have to use my parentheses. So three times, I'm gonna put parentheses, negative one parentheses squared, because we know that means to turn positive. And if you don't put those parentheses, your calculator won't tell you that it's positive. And that gives me an answer of two. Means then is that G of F of zero is equal to two. Okay, so that's composition with the value, a lot more straightforward. We're getting just a simplified number as our solution. In the last example, we're going to kind of do everything together and pull it all into a word problem. So if we need more practice, there is this, try it on page 99. So example six tells us that clothes you wear post discounts on social media. The store allows customers to use multiple discounts. They simply need to tell the cashier in which order they would like the discounts to be applied. So on your next trip to clothes you wear, which order should you ask for the discount? So we want to see which one is going to give us the better deal, right? We want to pay less for our purchase. So we're going to write out the functions that model the discounts, letting X represent the price of the purchase. Okay, so if I have discount option A here, which is $5 off. So if X represents the price of my purchase and I'm taking away $5 from that purchase, right? I'm getting $5 off that purchase. That would mean that I would do X minus five for that function, right? So $5 off would mean I subtract $5 from my total price of the purchase. 10% off would mean that I am taking 10% away from my purchase. So if my purchase is X dollars, then 10% is 0.1. of my purchase, right? So 10% written as a decimal is 0.1. Okay, so 10% off my purchase means I'm taking my purchase and I'm taking away 0.1 times that purchase. A faster way to do this is to think about how much I'm actually paying for the item, right? So if I have 10% off, I'm actually paying 90%, right? So I'm paying 90% of the value or 0.9x. It's not a lot neater looking of a function, right? If I had 1x, my total cost minus 10% is 90%. I'm paying 90% of the total cost. And so I would always do it that way. It just makes it a little cleaner and makes a little more sense, right? If I'm getting 10% off, I'm paying 90%. So I'm just subtracting that from 100. Okay, so option A is asking for us to take the 10% off, then $5 off. So when I'm creating this function, that means they actually want us to find f of g of x, right? We're evaluating g of x first, right? We're taking 10% off first, and then we're taking off $5. Versus option B is I would take off the $5 first. So f would be the second thing I write down in my composition. Then I'm taking 10% off. So g of f would be that. Okay, so let's evaluate and kind of see what this means. So we want to see which one will give us a lower cost. So if I'm doing f of g of x, that means I'm doing f of g of x is 0.9x. Okay, so I'm taking f, which is x minus 5, so x minus 5, and instead of x, I'm putting in that 0.9x. This function's nice because it was just x, so it's 0.9x minus 5. Okay, so that's option A. I'm paying 90% of the cost minus $5. Okay, so then let's look at it backwards. So if I have g of f of x, I'm looking at first subtracting $5. So I'm going to replace the x in g of x. So this x here, remember that I'm using this equation for g, not the first expression. So I'm taking my g function, which is 0.9 times x, and I'm going to replace x with my function for f, which was x minus 5. So 0.9 times x minus 5, if I distribute the 0.9x, minus, if I multiply, if we think about 9 times 5 is 45, right? So that's going to be 4.5 if I multiply 0.9 times 5. So I get 0.9x minus 45. Okay, so if I look at these, I want to figure out which one's the better deal, right? Which one am I paying less for? So if I'm paying 90% of the cost minus 5, $5 versus 90% of the total cost minus $4.50, I have a better deal for option A. If for some reason I couldn't tell that from the equation, I could just try this with a shirt that costs $30. So for A, F of G of 30 would be 0.9 times 30 minus 5 would be $22. Versus if I look at the same thing for B, G of F of 30 would be 0.9 times 30 minus 4.5. That's going to give me $22.50. Okay, so I'm saving 50 cents by choosing option A.